Hi, my name is Brian Slomovitz. I'm the Director of Gynecologic Oncology at the Sylvester Comprehensive Cancer Center, part of the University of Miami. Today I want to discuss some of the really highlights of the ASCO meeting as it pertains to gynecologic cancers and some of the exciting results that we're learning about at this meeting. There's going to be three different studies that I talk about that are all being highlighted in the oral abstract session for gynecologic cancers. The first study, it's the LION study, looked at the evaluation of removing lymph nodes at the time of surgery for ovarian cancer. The investigators were looking to determine if they removed all the lymph nodes in patients, whether that would actually help patients with ovarian cancer live longer. It's something that was controversial in our field, and we weren't really sure in those patients who had widely spread disease that already spread to the abdomen, whether removing lymph nodes were worthwhile or not. It was an important trial to do. The investigators did a good job in performing a proper study. And what they found was removing lymph nodes in those patients who already had stage 3 or 4 disease by other means, meaning spread to the abdominal cavity or spread to the liver or the lung, in those patients, it was not required to remove lymph nodes. The outcome was the same, whether lymph nodes were removed or not, but by removing lymph nodes, it added surgical time, it added blood loss, and the potential for different morbidities and side effects of the surgery. So the investigators found that it was not worthwhile to remove those lymph nodes, and patients could do just as well. That's one of the important findings that we found here at this meeting. Another study is the desktop study. This was an interesting study performed on a multi-institutional study through our European colleagues. What they did is they looked at patients with ovarian cancer and those that recurred from ovarian cancer. They recurred from their ovarian cancer greater than 6 months from their time of previous chemotherapy. What they wanted to see is whether or not there was a benefit of surgery in these patients, whether operating on these women can help them, in fact, live longer. What they found, and this is very exciting, what they found is that surgical debulking or removal of tumor in those patients with recurrent disease can actually lead to a longer progression-free survival. It's a longer time that the patients live without needing treatment. This is a very exciting finding, an exciting outcome, and we're really going to be waiting on overall survival data to see if it will come into full practice. But right now, it's being offered more and more as an option for our patients who recur. It's unfortunate that recurred, but if we can remove the disease at the time of their recurrence, those patients do better. The third trial that I want to discuss deals with endometrial cancer. In patients with endometrial cancer who are at high risk for recurrence, we know that giving them chemotherapy is an option in addition to the radiation therapy that was always the standard of care. What this study did, this is the PORTEC-3 trial. PORTEC-3. They evaluated giving patients radiation and they wanted to determine whether adding chemotherapy was in fact beneficial. What they found through this study is they found that giving chemotherapy to these patients was not necessary. Radiation by itself was useful in decreasing recurrences in those patients with high-risk endometrial cancer. Further studies will need to be done. However, we're finding that radiation therapy for those patients with stage 1 cancer is enough and it's not needed to add chemotherapy. Those are really three of the major highlights that we found at this year's ASCO meeting, and we're looking forward to the results of several other ongoing trials that will be presented at next year's meeting. Thank you.